Hello everyone, I hope you are all well and healthy. Meet me again, at Perro's Cement Techno Channel. On this occasion I will explain about the rotary kiln system used in the combustion process at the cement plant. Rotary kiln is a rotating combustion process equipment, in which there is a high temperature or range from 1100 to 1500 degrees Celsius for the clinker production process. The heat source comes from the main burner, and the inside of the rotary kiln is lined with refractory brick to protect against high temperatures. For the two things above, we will explain in the next video session. And in this session we will explain about the function and working principle of rotary kiln support equipment. Before I continue this discussion, I would like to thank those of you who have subscribed and supported this channel. And for those of you who haven't subscribed, please subscribe first, so you can take advantage of this video material. What is kiln in cement industry? Rotary kiln is a unit process used in cement production, in which limestone is decomposed into calcium oxide, which forms the basis of cement clinker particles under high temperature. The rotary kiln is also known as the heart of the cement factory, because if this kiln unit stops, all other units in the cement production process will stop. The value of the size of the production capacity and the value of good or bad cement quality are also determined in this kiln unit. As we all know, the cement production line includes three main stages, including the process of preparing cement raw materials, clinker production process, and finished cement production process. The rotary kiln is equipped with several supporting equipment, including 1. Kiln tire and supporting roller. Kiln tire and supporting roller are used to support the rotary kiln and allow it to rotate with minimal friction due to its flat and smooth surface. What is kiln tire? Rotary kiln tire, also called rolling ring, is one important part of rotary kiln. It transmits all gravity of rotary kiln, including refractory bricks, internal devices, and raw material, to supporting roller, and ensures that kiln rotates smoothly on supporting roller, and strengthen the radial behavior. The number of tires is 2 or 3 in a rotary kiln. This depends on the design of the rotary kiln system. The rotational movement of tire and kiln shell is slightly different because of the gap. We can also call it migration. What is kiln migration? Generally, migration tell us about available gap in between kiln tire and kiln shell. Measuring unit in millimeter, which calculate by the RPM lagging between tire and kiln shell. Higher value and lower value both are dangerous for the kiln lining and kiln shell as well. Supporting roller. The supporting roller bears the entire weight of the rotary kiln, including the kiln, inner bricks, raw materials, kiln tire, rotary drive gear, which makes the kiln and tire rotate smoothly on the supporting roller kiln. Supporting rollers are installed on 2 or 3 kiln foundations, and the roller rotates to support the kiln through the kiln tire, can be seen as in this video. Three, kiln drive is equipment whose function is to rotate the rotary kiln. Kiln drive type, auxiliary drive and main drive. Auxiliary drive function is to rotate the rotary kiln with low rotation, 0.2 RPM, usually used when heating up the kiln and during the kiln stop process or when repairing the rotary kiln. The main drive functions to rotate the rotary kiln with variable rotation from 0.4 RPM to 5 RPM, depending on the rotary kiln design. The kiln is rotated using one or two motor drives. And to change the high rotation of the electric motor using a gear reducer, then through the pinion gear it is continued to the girth gear to rotate the kiln. In its development to rotate the kiln, it does not use motor drives including gear reducer, pinion gear and girth gear, but uses a supporting roller as the drive which is rotated using an electrohydraulic drive system with four drive units. This type of rotary kiln uses only two kiln foundations, as seen in this video. Four, thrust roller. The thrust roller is an important auxiliary part of the rotary kiln. It is designed to control the axial movement of the rotary kiln, so that the tires and supporting rollers can be evenly distributed over their full width. The thrust roller is controlled using a hydraulic pump, with a pressure of 50 to 100 bar. Five, kiln seal whose function is to prevent air leakage at the kiln inlet and kiln outlet. There are several types of kiln seals, including kiln spring seals, graphite block seals, pneumatic seals, and lamella seals, as seen in this example image. That was the explanation about the rotary kiln in general, and in the next video we will explain about the burner and the combustion process in the kiln system. Thank you for watching this video, hopefully it's useful, and don't forget to subscribe, like and comment, and share it with your friends who need it. See you in the next video.